GNR, or Great North Roads, produce 1/35th scale plaster, buildings and scenery bases. When combined with 1/35th scale vehicles and figures, these make effective backdrops for your models. GNR models are cast in a fine, dense plaster that holds detail well, but these are heavy. Detailed castings mean there are few parts. Some GNR kits are just a single item. Here, packed well in a sturdy box, we have a single piece diorama base, titled the train platform. The plaster is smooth and dust free and is an ideal base on which to paint, which this clip aims to demonstrate. A cheap black primer applied from a spray can gives a smooth base that helps accentuate shadows and recesses. Our demonstration of GNR casts' suitability to paint starts with humbles enamels. Next, some cheap craft acrylic. Like the enamel, this goes on very easily with good coverage. Acrylics again, this time from Citadel Miniatures. Here we are using a household emulsion, which dries with a nice matte finish. The fine detail exhibited in casts from Great North Roads can be emphasised with an airbrush. After drying, I'm now going to look at some other products that can be used on the Great North Roads bases. Unprimed plaster will absorb inks, lessening the colour intensity, but over a painted layer, ink washes will add depth and outline. Finally, we're going to use Life Colour pigment. We're going to apply this, rubbing it into the detail on the cobblestone surface. Water is applied, the pigment turns to sludge, which we'll remove by wiping, leaving the dust effect ingrained into the cobblestones. The aim of this demonstration was to highlight how easy it is to bring out the cast detail of Great North Roads products. Also to show how receptive the bases are to a wide range of paint types. We'll be revisiting this diorama base in a later video, showing how it can be incorporated into a full diorama.